Hello friends, this is Bright here. In this video, I am going to explain how we can extract text from the image by using Android and Google ML Kit. So let me start with Android Studio. And this is my Android Studio version, Android Studio 4.0. So I'm going to create a new project. So I'm selecting MD activity here. So let us say that text demo, some name for the project. And here I'm going with Java language. Then I'm going to use minimum API 23. This is the main activity.java, and I am going to take activity main.xml. So here the constraint layout is given. I am going to proceed with linear layout. So let us say that orientation is vertical. Then here I am going to use an image view, so that which image we are going to take through the camera, that will be displayed here. So let us say layout width wrap content, layout height wrap content. Let us give an ID. Can say that image ID. So below to that I'm going to keep a button. So this button is to open the cam and take the picture. That is the purpose. So let us say that width is match parent, height is wrap content, and I'm going to use the on click. So let us say that do process. Now when you click the button, there will be a function named do process. That function will be automatically called. And this function we have to write it in main activity.java. So there you can see that an error is displaying. So you can take the error indicator and you can see the option create do process view in main activity. Just click it. We can see that automatically the method is created. So when you click this button, this method will be automatically called. And below to that, I am going to keep a text view. So the purpose of this text view is, after extracting the text, we have to display it. For that purpose, I am using this text view. Let us say that layout width wrap content, height wrap content. I'm using an ID, let us say text ID. Yeah. So we have three components inside the linear layout. And we can see the design also. Can use the split option. Go to the main activity. So let us declare a variable of type image view, and for the text view also text view. And find the image view and text view. To find the image view, we can use find v by id r dot id dot, there we used image id. So it can be given to the reference variable image view, then find text view for that, find v by id r dot id dot text id, and it can be given to text view. And now we are going to check that whether app level permission is given for using the camera. Check app level permission is granted for using camera. For that, we are going to write a condition. We are going to check. There is a method like this: check self permission, and inside use the manifest class. You can see manifest is a predefined class in Android manifest, and you can see its package is imported android.manifest. So manifest dot permission dot camera. If it is not granted, we have to prompt the user to grant the permission. That is what we are going to do it. For that, you can see I've just put capital P, it will show permission granted or permission denied. We are going to check permission granted. Just enter. You can see automatically the coding is generated, package manager dot permission granted. So if it is not granted, we are going to say that grant the permission. So we are going to prompt the user to grant the permission. For that, there is a method request permissions. It is a predefined method. Then you can see there are two arguments we have to pass: an array of permissions followed by the request code. So it is a string array, new. You can see automatically the format will be coming through the coding assistance. Manifest dot permission dot camera. You can see that camera's type is string data type. Camera. Then the second argument, request code. So I'm going to give 101. Any integer value we can give here. The purpose of do process function is when we click that button, we have to open the camera. Got it? So we are going to write the code how to open the camera now. So before that, we have to mention the specific permission to use camera in manifest file. Don't forget. So let us finish it first. Go to manifest. We can see in manifest folder android manifest.xml file. Above the application tag, just open the angular bracket. You can see that user's permission, and you can see camera. Select it, then put the closing one. So this is mandatory. Now, so how to open the camera? So we have a camera app in our mobile. Through the indent, we are going to open it. So to open the camera, what we are going to do is we are going to create an indent object. For that, indent, give some name equal new indent, and here I am going to mention an argument. There is a class called media store. Mention that action image capture. So this property we have to provide to open the camera through the indent. To start the activity or to start the camera, we have to use start activity. But now I am not going to use start activity. There is another method called start activity for reset, because our intention is after taking the picture, we have to continue something. Start activity for result, and here pass the indent object which we created, followed by the request code. Here we mentioned that request code is 101. There is a predefined method on activity result. So I'll explain how this function will be called. So once the camera operation is over, this function will be automatically called, and here we are going to do our remaining steps. That is, we are going to process the image to extract the text from it. Hope that it is clear. Now we are going to take the image first and set it in the image view. For that, I am going to take this indent argument, that is data dot get extras. You can see that it returns a bundle instance. So declare a variable of type bundle. From the bundle object, extract the image. For that, bundle dot, we can use this first method get, and the key name should be data. And this extracted data, that is the extracted image, can be stored in a reference variable of type bitmap. You can see bitmap, it is in the package android.graphics bitmap. So I'm declaring a reference of type bitmap and it is storing here. But you should know one thing, the signature of get method, you can see that it returns object type. So directly we cannot assign to bitmap. You can see it shows an error. Take the error indicator and say that cast to bitmap. Yeah, so it is automatically, the code is generated for typecasting. And now we can set the image in image view. For that, we have the image view reference, image view dot. You can see there is a predefined method, set image bitmap. So pass the bitmap instance. Now after setting the image in image view, now we are going to process our image. Process the image to extract the text. We are going to use the Firebase. For that, we can see the menu here, tools. From the tools menu, you can see a menu item, Firebase. Select it. We can see ML kit, machine learning kit. Expand it. So here we are going to use the ML kit to recognize text in images. So the second option. Now a series of steps we have to follow. So this is a very easy step I am going to explain. No need to go to the browser directly. So from here itself we can give the instruction. First, connect to Firebase. You can see that a window will come like this. So already I have few existing projects in Firebase, or if you want to create a fresh one, you can go with the fresh one. Those who are doing it for the first time, select the first one, create a new Firebase project. Then you may click connect to Firebase. And now we can see the status, Firebase project created and connected locally to our module app. And the next step is add the ML kit to our app. So just click this option and you can see performing this action will make the following changes to your project. A dependence will be added. And say accept changes. Now the step 3, auto download ML model. And you can see optional but recommended. So what we are going to do is I am going to use on-device API, just copy it and put it in our manifest file within the application tag. So go to manifest. You should be very careful. It should be within the application but outside the activity. Just paste it. I'm going to close manifest. And now we are going to do the fourth step. How we can recognize text in images. You can see default some code is available. Firebase vision image dot from bitmap. This is what we are going to do. But before going to proceed, we have to do a very important step. What we have to do is open the browser and type console.firebase.google.com and log in using your Gmail account. And this is the project I created in Firebase. We can see text demo. So from the Android Studio itself, we have done all the procedures. So you can see in which name the project is given. In that name, you can see your project in Firebase console. Open it. Click settings, select project settings, and here you can see Google services JSON file. This I am going to download it from here, and you can see it is downloading, and its name will be like this, Google services.json. If you are downloading multiple times, then it will give like this services-2. Then you have to remove that -2. So the name should be google-services.json. Be very careful. Now copy the JSON file. So I'm just copying it. Copy. and right click the app folder and select paste. You can see the option here, paste it. So the name is okay. Yes, it is added. If you want to see that file here, here you can see it is showing as Android option. Select to project, and now you will be able to see inside app there is a file called google-services.json. Now the first step is, here you can see that the step number 4, create a Firebase vision image object from a bitmap object. So this is the first step. So I'm just copying that step name. Step number 1, create a Firebase vision image object from a bitmap. For that, declare a reference of Firebase. You can see that the supporting package is not available. So what we have to do is, we have to build this project. Select make project. You can see the status, Gradle build is running. Yeah, so now we can proceed. Now we can see that the supportive packages are downloaded. So use the Firebase vision image. So declare a variable type. So I'm going to use Firebase vision image equal Firebase vision image dot from bitmap. So already we have a bitmap instance, so that we have to paste it here. So this is the first step we have to do. And the second step is get an instance of Firebase vision. For that, I am going to use a reference variable of type Firebase vision equal to Firebase vision dot get instance. And the third step is create an instance of Firebase vision text recognizer. Firebase vision text recognizer. For that, I am going to use a reference variable of type Firebase vision text recognizer. And now use the Firebase vision instance. Dot. And here you can see a getter method, get on device text recognizer. So these are the three important steps we have to do. The first step is create a Firebase vision image object from the bitmap object we have, then get the instance of type Firebase vision, then using the Firebase vision call the method get on device text recognizer, which returns an object of type Firebase vision text recognizer. By using this object we can recognize the text. For that, what we are going to do is Fourth step, create a task to process the image. For that, using the Firebase Vision Text Recognizer, we can call the method process image. So this is the method I am going to use. And see, we have to pass an argument of type Firebase Vision Image to process image, and the process image returns an object of type task Firebase Vision Text. So process image, Firebase Vision Image, we have to pass it, and it returns an object of type task Firebase Vision Text. Hope that it is clear. Using the Firebase Vision Text Recognizer, call the method process image. So in process image, we have to pass Firebase Vision Image instance. The process image returns an object of type task. Next, step number 5. If the task is success, we can give some response to the user. Otherwise, if the task is failure, some response we can show to user. So how it can be done? It is very simple. For that, use the task object, task dot, there is a method called add on success listener. If the task is success, so add on success listener, type new, press control space. You can see there is a method on success listener. Just select it, and you can see automatically the code is generated. And here, don't forget to put semicolon. Now there is no error. Similarly, if the task is failure, how some response can be shown to user? For that, we can use again task object dot add on failure listener, and inside again type new, give some space and press control space bar, and you can see on failure listener. You can see automatically the code is generated, and don't forget to put semicolon here. So if it is success, we are going to display the text. For that, here we can see we have an argument of type Firebase Vision Text. So the text which is extracted will be available in this argument. So we can take the text first, Firebase Vision Text dot get text, and this can be set in our text view. So we can store it in some string variable. Let us say that s equal to, and take our text view and call the method set text s. If it is failure, we can just give a toast, make text, get application context. We can say that failure, or even we can use this exception object, exception object dot get message, and we can say length long dot show. So that's all about the coding. Now I am going to run in my mobile. So here I'm going to mirror my mobile so that you can see the status. So here I'm going to use a tool called SCR CPY. Yes, the device is connected. And this is Android 8. Minimize the terminal, don't close it if you are using the same tool. Now I am going to run it. So it is asking install through USB. Yes. So it is asking, allow to take pictures and record video. Hello. Oh, I didn't keep any label for the button. No problem, just click it. So I'm going to take an image. Yeah. So the image is taken. I'm going to select it. You can see the image is shown in image view and the extracted text is available here. And to make it better, let us give some text for our button. So button can say text equal. Take the picture. Yeah. So let me run the app. We can see again it is launching. Yeah, now take pic. So this is another input. Yeah, you can see successfully it is extracted. Hope that you understand it. Thank you for watching this video.